Okay, so apparently ThemeForest has accessible themes you can buy, and I've also seen what people who have made WordPress websites with an accessible theme, and some of my students have told me that that's actually a thing. So I decided to check how accessible those themes are. And whenever a service, or rather a software, is advertised as accessible, I'm always very hesitant to believe them because nine times out of 10, these softwares are not accessible and they're just using that as a marketing tactic. Or what they did is that they tried to make it WCAG accessible without understanding anything about accessibility. So you have like all the elements have a title attribute or something. Anyways, so I decided to check out these templates, and I haven't checked them out before. This will be the first time I do it. So you're gonna see my reaction. I will not see, but here. So let's go to the search bar and write accessible themes. Okay, accessible themes. And then we have the first one, which is called Polyclinic Accessible Medical WordPress Theme. I cannot tell you guys how many times I have gone to doctors' websites and they're not accessible, which is an irony. It's also pretty sad though. Okay, so it has 375 sales and 77 comments, and it has 5 rating out of 12 ratings. Okay, so let me see if it says the WCAG anywhere. Like Polyclinic theme passes WCAG level AA and section 508 accessibility requirements. Okay, surpasses WordPress accessibility requirements. I didn't know WordPress had any accessibility requirements. WordPress is pretty shit when it comes to accessibility, so I would not really trust that. And let's see the other passes WCAG. See, just if your website passes WCAG, that doesn't mean it's accessible, okay? Because especially when it's advertised that it passes WCAG, a lot of the time they just tell their developers, hey, we need this to be WCAG 2.1 conformant. So they check the WCAG and like, oh, we need title attributes everywhere. This doesn't really put any faith in me. disabilities friendly barrierless. Okay. That's kind of a weird wording here. User friendly, keyboard and screen reader friendly, that's good. With proper heading structure, sufficient color contrast, content font. Okay, so they try to, make it to say exactly what they made accessible, which is okay. Mega menus are not really accessible. Okay, but let me open this website and see if it really is accessible. Okay, so let me do a visual test first. So they say they have mega menus. So the mega menu open on hover, which means that it must be dismissible with escape. So let me press escape and see if it's dismissible. I am pressing escape and the mega menu doesn't disappear. So right here they have broken the WCAG guideline. Excuse me, WCAG success criterion. Content on hover. So good start, I say ironically. Okay. What else? Let me do a quick visual test. The contrast seems okay, but I haven't tested it. Okay, so I see another violation. This form has no labels. Okay, this doesn't have a label. The search doesn't have a label, and the drop downs don't have labels. So they're violating WCAG success criterion for labels. Okay, so another WCAG. I just opened this website, excuse me, I just opened this theme, and like 5 minutes in, I find 2 violations of WCAG success criterion. Like, I know I made fun of them already, like, oh, if it's really WCAG conformant, that doesn't mean it's accessible, but it's not even WCAG conformant, okay? Guys, they really messed that up. Okay, so that's bad. The links are underlined in bold, that's good. Animation. It's under 5 seconds, so I'll give it a pass. Explore services. Animation. It's a theme, so they must put a lot of animations, but it's under 5 seconds, not like automatic animation that plays. The links are good. This is the testimonials. They're good too. And let's see the footer. No label. The same WCAG violation. Topics. Okay, the contrast is off on the hover, which is not good. Okay, so it's not good, but I guess it could be worse. Let me do a keyboard test. So let me start tabbing. Okay, that's not good. Let me go back, shift with tab. Okay, let's start at the beginning of the site. Skip to main navigation. Okay, skip link. That's good. Skip to main content. Good. Skip to footer. Too many skip links, I think. Yeah. I would only add one skip link. But I am nitpicking here. I mean, they have conformed to the WCAG success criterion bypass block here, so I'm just being mean. It's fine. Ooh. Okay. Why are we not selecting Polyclinic? Okay. Sorry. That's a logo. The logo looks like a button. So that's not good, but it's not a violation, but it's still not good. Okay. Why have we selected this? Why have we selected this? I wonder, is this the phone number? Okay, so it's a phone number with. Okay, those are supposed to be. Huh. Okay, why is. Oh, okay, so there's the mail and the phone number. That's a violation of guideline predictable. And okay, so the phone number is actually. It's not a phone number. It's not marked up as a phone number, okay? It redirects to the contact page. However, it looks like a phone number. You know what I mean? So if I want to call, if I'm using a screen reader and I'm wanting to call and I press the URL is gonna say the phone number. So I'm gonna try to call them, but I'll instead be redirected to the contact page. Yeah, that's another violation of WCAG predictable and label in name as well. That's just messed up. Okay, they messed it up again. Yeah, that's no good. They haven't marked up the phone number correctly. Besides, if I try, they also have these weird stuff in it, like these vertical bars. Like what? That's so weird. Why would you do that? That's not accessible. Okay, let's go. Tab. Okay. They're violating another success criterion. Oh my god, they're just violating WCAG left and right. Okay, so I'm going to press. See, that's the issue because if it activates on focus, if I want, for example, I want to go to patients and visitors, but I can't. I have to go through the whole thing. So that's no good. See, every time I want to go anywhere, I have to go through the whole thing. It's terrible. By the theme. No thanks. It's a terrible theme. Okay. Search. Okay. Their outline is not so good. Their form is terrible. There is no instructions on top saying which fields are mandatory. There are no labels. Do they even have area labels on those? What? No, they don't. They don't seem like to have area labels on the form fields. Oh my god, that's terrible. This is not accessible. I'm gonna stop browsing it because I don't want to spend the whole video just browsing one theme, but don't buy this. Okay, let's see Angelica, accessible bookstore WordPress theme. Let's go to one that have a lot of. And this one has so many sales and so many. I know what happens. People who want accessible website, they just buy it, install it, and they say they're accessible. Sad. They're being misled. In my opinion, I guess. Yeah, in my opinion. This one has a lot of sales. Let's open and see. I'm not gonna read the description because obviously there's just gonna be a line in there. In my opinion. Yet your website is not gonna be accessible if it doesn't load. Okay. So that's what kind of theme is that? Accessible business portfolio and WooCommerce WordPress theme. Okay, so that's an e-store. Yeah, I don't think that's gonna be accessible. Again, the menu appears on hover. So if it appears on hover, that means it must be dismissible on escape key. So I'm gonna press escape. Now dismissible. Again, they're violating the same We have success criterion code on hover, of course. Still no label, although it has this looking glass, which technically makes it a label. Let me see if it has an area label. It just disappears when I try to see it, but never mind. Okay, let's go down. Okay, so it has... So this is supposed to be a video, a hero background video, okay? And it has a pause button, which would technically satisfy our WooCommerce success criterion for automatic animations and videos. However, this button is not... doesn't have a good contrast. So this fails success criterion for contrast. And the links are okay. I don't think this contrast is good. I haven't tested it because I'm not able to do inspect element, but just looking at it, of course, I could be wrong. Always test the contrast with a 2, but I don't like how this looks. Okay, and add to cart, these are the cards. The inspect element doesn't work, so I'm just gonna do visual here first. And okay, so contrast is good. Bad contrast again. This theme, just the contrast is bad. At least the medical theme had a good contrast for the most part. Okay, our story, good links, bad contrast. Okay, let me try with the keyboard. Go to the beginning of the site. I don't know what's happening. What's happening? I'm trying to get into the beginning of the site. Okay. Skip the name and navigation. Okay, skip links. Okay, it's focusing the logo, which means the logo is a link. That's fine. So, okay, again, violating success criterion on focus. They weren't actually violating the success criterion on focus. It's my bad. It will only be a violation if the on focus causes a change of context, which in this case it wasn't. There's a violation. Again, I have to, oh my god, it has, their submenus have sub-submenus. Oh my god, that's terrible. So I have to go through every single submenu to get to the next one. Oh my god, nobody ever tested this website. Ooh, that's bad, that's very bad. The focus order doesn't match the DOM order. Another way to access criteria violation. See, cause, oh no. So I'm at the Vimeo icon, so I expect the next focusable element to be go shopping, but if I press tab, I go to the top. This is really, really bad for people who use screen magnifiers, for people with screen readers who use screen readers and who are sighted, or people with screen readers who have blind users with screen readers who have a sighted user helping them. The focus order should always follow the DOM order, but it doesn't here. Oh my god. Okay, what's happened there? I don't know where I am. So I have focused something and my focus has disappeared. And I don't know where I am, and this is terrible. If I press tab again, I have focused the pause button. Okay, let me try to activate it with spacebar. Okay, at least that's working. So that's good, even though the focus is shit. Okay, so we have selected the link. The link is violating success criterion for links. I forgot which one it was, but this link is not. Oh, excuse me. This link is not underlined or have a different color, even on focus. So in a resting state, it looks okay, but on focus, it looks bad. So this is another success criterion violation. And oops. So I have selected the card, I pressed tab again, and I want to select options. I pressed tab again, and my focus has disappeared again. Oh, that's bad. Okay, skip to main navigation. Skip back to main navigation. Why is there a skip link here? That's not technically a violation, but just annoys. Like, why would I want to go back to main navigation? Why do you have a skip link here if you have a back to top button here? That's weird, but it's not a violation, just an annoyance. These links have no underline, so they're violating WGAC. This doesn't have a label, visible label. It technically has this, which could be, like, it's a gray area. I would fail this, but some accessibility specialists would let it pass because of the looking glass. These links are not accessible. Okay. So this website is not accessible at all. Let me go into the shop. I'm gonna use my mouse because with the keyboard it's gonna take me centuries. What? They haven't done a good job with their theme. Like, I'm trying to see their theme and it will not redirect me. Like, I'm going to the shop. This is the name of testing purposes. No order shall be fulfilled. Okay, dismissed, whatever. Okay, welcome to our shop. Okay, let's go tap again. Oh no, I don't want to tap through the terrible navigation. Let me start shop. Okay, let me start here. Let me start here. I am unable to select sort by latest. This I'm unable to select it with the keyboard, which violates weak access criterion keyboard. So that means all interactive elements should be accessible with the keyboard, and this is not. And this element is not accessible with the keyboard either. So there are two buttons doing the same thing. It's not a violation, but it's annoyance. If you actually cared about accessibility, you wouldn't have allowed this to happen, but they obviously don't. So this is a huge violation. Who said this theme was accessible? And I'm selecting the cards, but I get no outline. So focus visible success criterion is being violated here. I don't know where I am. The whole outline has disappeared. What? What? Am I doing something wrong? Yes, the whole outline has disappeared in the shop. Let's see a third theme that has a lot of sales. Oh, this one has 3 stars, probably not accessible. This one has 2.1k sales, so it should be accessible. I'm just gonna look. I'm very tired, and these inaccessible themes that try to pass themselves as accessible just make me nauseous. Okay, so let's try with the keyboard again. Okay, focus visible. Anyone heard of focus visible, which is a level A WCAG success criterion? No, just me. Okay. No focus visible. What happened? Is it my computer? Their website. Oh dear. Okay, let's go here. Build your body strong. Okay, that sounds good. Okay, tabbing. See what I mean? I think they did this phone number correctly. Yes, they marked it up as tell and they hit the icon, which is good. So when you click on it or tap on it, on the phone it will actually ring instead of redirecting you to the contact page. That was just weird. Okay, so go back. Okay, I can see the focus. Okay, this is not so bad. Focus order doesn't follow tab order. Let me activate. Okay, so I activated it. Oh, I activated it, but how do I click on it? I don't know what's happening. I'm trying to search for it, but then it just. So I activated the button, but it wouldn't focus the body of the input itself. Okay, go away. Another weak access criterion. I'm keyboard. Focus. A meaningful relation, meaningful sequence, excuse me, was violated here. And my focus disappeared, so I don't know where I am. Wait. Yes, it disappeared. I think I'm selecting these guys here. Yes, I'm selecting these guys. Okay, I can actually see them. Signed up, okay. I don't know where I am. My focus disappeared again. I think I'm selecting these things. Let me do enter. Yeah, I was selecting these cards. But there's no outline. Okay, I'm tired. These themes are not accessible at all. Like, I just do a basic keyboard test and it fails the WCAG. I don't know what's gonna happen if I fire up my screen reader. So what I wanted to tell you is, moral of the story is, if you're buying an accessible theme, make sure you test it's actually accessible, because these obviously aren't. Never take the merchant on their word that something is accessible, because a lot of them lie, okay? And make sure you test with screen reader, with your keyboard, visual testing. Just do the whole thing before you buy, because they like to say things that aren't true. And it's bad enough that a lot of themes and services and software is not accessible, but to lie that it's accessible is, in my opinion, really bad. So that's it. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you later.